Here's what you will need. Scissors. Phillips head screwdriver. What's in the box? Ankle brackets, Allen key and washers. Ankle bracket screws. Hockey laces and wire feeder. Dial mount with attached dial. After removing existing hockey laces, attach ankle brackets using screws. Insert silver hollow screw through the top eyelet from the inside of the skate. From the outside of the skate, push the left ankle bracket into place over the silver hollow screw. Tighten fully with screwdriver on the black screw and Allen key on the silver screw. Repeat this step for the lower portion of the ankle bracket. Repeat all of these steps for the right ankle bracket on the other side of the skate. Attach system to skate. Undo the wire from the dial mount. Pull up on the dial to loosen the system and release the wires from coiled position. Take left wire and insert it into the wire feeder. Feed wire feeder into the top hole of the left ankle bracket and out the bottom hole. Take right wire and insert it into the wire feeder. Feed wire feeder into the top hole of the right ankle bracket and out the bottom hole. Mark off or keep an eye where the dial mount is in correct position before you remove the white film. Remove white film from the top right corner of the dial mount and place mount on tongue in correct position. Lacing the skate. Going across the skate, feed one end of the wire through the loop of the dial mount. Enter the fourth eyelet from the outside of the skate and pull down towards the toe. Repeat these steps on the other side of the skate. Run wire on the inside of the skate and feed wire through the third eyelet from the toe, going from inside to out. Repeat these steps with other end of the wire. Cross over into the first eyelet from the toe, going from the outside to in. Slack before tying. Before tying the two wires together, make sure you have enough wire slack for your foot to go in. To assure this, make sure the dial is popped up and loosened. Pull the tongue of the skate outwards enough so that there is a finger width of space between the tongue and the wall of the skate. Attaching the wire ends. Attach both ends of the wire to each other by creating a triple knot. Below is a detailed video of how to do this. Tightly pull both ends of the wire away from the knot to ensure there's a secure knot. To test out tightening the skate, press the dial down and turn clockwise to tighten system. Install stretchy hockey laces provided. Loosen the skate by pulling the dial up and pulling away the tongue. Take the hockey lace and feed through all the eyelets, just like you would any hockey skate. Do your best to stay over the wire the entire time lacing. Stop feeding hockey lace once you've gotten to the ankle bracket and tie a regular knot. Here's how it should look. We hope you love using twist lace. Enjoy being the first one on the ice. Thanks for watching. Going across the skate, feed one end of the wire through the loop of the dial mount and enter from the inside of the skate into the third, fourth, or fifth eyelet from the toe, whichever has the least path of resistance. Repeat these steps for other end of the wire. Going across the skate, feed the wire into the first eyelet going from outside to in. Repeat this step for the other wire. Pull tongue outwards so that there is a finger width of room between the wall of the skate and the tongue. Keep the skate in this position and begin to tie the triple knot. Here is a detailed video of how to properly do this. Once completed, pull both ends of the wire to make sure the knot is secured. Make sure dial is pressed down and turn it clockwise to tighten. This will test the system. Take your scissors and cut the excess wire. Leave about 2 centimeters of wire on each end. Loosen the skate by pulling up on the dial and releasing the system. Take the hockey lace and feed through all of the eyelets, just like you would any hockey skate. Do your best to stay over the wire the entire time lacing. Lacing the skate for a hidden knot. Once you've reached the last empty eyelet, feed the hockey lace from outside to in. Repeat this step for other end of the lace. Take the tip of the hockey lace and slide it through the washer. The washer should be slid all the way to the wall of the skate tightly. Tie a regular knot on the outside of the washer as close to the wall as you can. Repeat these steps for the other end of the lace. Test if you can get your foot in and out of the skate before cutting off the excess lace. Cut excess lace 2 centimeters above the knot. To avoid the fraying of the lace, you can use a lighter to singe the end of the frayed area. arguably the most important step in the video, tie yourself a twist lace bracelet and enjoy your new look. Here's how it should look. We hope you love using twist lace. Enjoy being the first one on the ice. Thanks for watching.